everyone. Thanks so much for watching Proactive New York. I'm Christine Corrado. Joining me right now is Simon Clarke from Apollo Gold and Silver. Simon, great to meet you. How are you?
I'm good, thanks. Surviving these crazy times, but very pleased to be here.
Good to hear, good to hear. Simon, let's kick it off with the name change that you went through recently from Apollo Gold to Apollo Silver and Gold. Talk me through that.
Yeah, so I mean, a lot of the early projects that we've been looking at have been more gold focused, but we are also seeing some really interesting opportunities on the silver side. It's obviously, you know, no surprise to anyone, silver has been strengthening. It kind of follows gold. So gold had a good run last year. Silver was a little slower off the mark, but you know, if you look at the relationship between gold and silver long term, you would say that silver is still significantly undervalued. It's also an industrial metal. And as the world recovers, as we move through 2021, you know, I think the industrial side of it will also become more and more important. So, you know, we're keen because we're seeing a lot on the silver side. It makes sense for us to also look at bringing some silver projects into our portfolio.
Can you tell us a bit more about that? Any target acquisitions you're looking at right now in terms of silver?
Well, so, I mean, Apollo Gold was launched in, you know, April, May of last year. So it's really the little sister of a company called Prime Mining, which my colleagues in this office have built over the last couple of years. And, you know, is at the point now where they've got, you know, a big initial resource. They're doing a lot more drilling. They've brought in a really experienced team, you know, on the gold side. Dan Kuntz is running it now, who was former CEO of Ivanhoe. And Murray John, who's a big, well-respected gold investor, is chairman of that company. So they've done a good job building it and evolving it. And so, you know, we launched Apollo with a goal really to focus on Latin America. And again, we really like the jurisdictions of Chile and Peru. Both of them are highly ranked by the Fraser Institute in terms of when you look at their geology, but also their fiscal and regulatory regimes, ability to get things done. And, you know, for us, it's we've started there. We've got some initial exploration projects, which we're excited about, but we also continue to look at a lot of other projects. You particularly look at Peru. I mean, Peru is one of those amazing countries where there's really big mines, and then there's a bunch of community mining done at a lower level. And a lot of that's explained because it's very mountainous. Infrastructure has traditionally been very poor, so you simply couldn't get to some of those areas. But over the last 10 years, they've grown their GDP very strongly. Their infrastructure started to go in. And so for exploration and development companies like us, there's some really big opportunities. So we're excited. Bank of America, for example, ranks Peru as the second best emerging market, or second best from a potential perspective. So we're really excited about it. Again, we're going to COVID dependent. We're going to start to do some work on our initial projects, but we continue to see a lot of deal flow through our relationship and the team that we've got here.
Yeah, obviously the coronavirus has posed quite the challenge in terms of getting work done. So what I guess is the latest work that you've done at your projects in Peru and in Chile?
Yeah, so I mean, in Chile, we acquired that asset in April last year and completed it with exchange approval and everything in August. So that was the start of the winter in the Southern Hemisphere. So not a lot we could do at that time. We were hoping to start to do some site visits and some initial work late last year. With COVID and the inability to travel, that's kind of been pushed out. But our goal for sure, and as part of our agreement, we will do an initial program in Chile, you know, as and when conditions ease and we can get people down there and crews up to site. So that's definitely a focus. In Peru, we have managed to do a little bit of work. The agreements we have there are still, you know, at the letter of intent stage. We are looking to move that to definitive agreements. But part of what we have to do to assess that, obviously, is get get some work done on site and validate the historic work there. And we've managed to do some of that. We were able to use some local geos to do a little bit of initial work. So we continue to assess that. And at the same time, as I mentioned, we're also seeing some, through the relationships we've built there, we're also seeing some other really interesting opportunities. So, you know, our goal is to build a portfolio of assets, not just on the exploration side, but assets that have had some mining on them or have some reserves already, brownfield with large scale exploration upside, which is where we've traditionally added a lot of value. If you look at Prime Mining, Millennial Lithium, American Lithium, a number of the projects that have come out of this office.
Well, I'm very much looking forward to following the story here, Simon. Thanks so much.
No problem. I really appreciate your time and stay safe out there.
Thanks, you too.
Cheers now.